It promises to be an electrifying experience. On this edition of Test Drive, the Chevrolet Volt. Listening to the radio the other day drove home just how little is known about the Chevrolet Volt. The commentator, in an off-script moment, was lamenting the fact that electric vehicles like the Nissan Leaf and Chevy Volt do not have the driving range demanded by the vast majority of commuters. While this is true of pure electric vehicles, most max out at about 160k on a good day, it is positively wrong when it comes to the Volt. What makes this Chevrolet Volt so very different is the fact that it's an extended range electric vehicle. Now, make no mistake, it is an electric vehicle because the electric motor does 100% of the driving. Now, there is a gasoline engine, but it drives a generator. The generator makes electricity, which is then consumed by the electric motor. Now, the advantage to that strategy, you will never get range anxiety. In simple terms, after charging the main 16 kilowatt hour lithium ion battery, the Volt purrs along using this power source for the first 45 or so kilometers. When that power is depleted, the Volt relies on its 63 horsepower 1.4 liter four cylinder engine. Furthering the economy driving range cause is a buffer that's contained within the main battery. This is used to store the electrical energy captured through regenerative braking and the excess power developed by the generator. It is this extension that allows the Volt to pull away electrically and run to about 50 plus K, even when the instrumentation says there's 0 kilometers of electric driving range left. I spy with my little eye something beginning with A. Now, if you're thinking Apple, you're right on the money. And the reason? The way this cockpit has been designed, it mimics many of Apple's products in as much as everything is touch sensitive. You touch here on the center stack, it picks that particular function. The screen, it too is touch sensitive. It all comes together and does away with the myriad knobs and buttons that plague so many other vehicles. As for the rest of it, well, this car comes one way, and that's loaded. While it all sounds very complicated, the manner in which the Volt operates is far simpler. Get on the gas and the Volt pulls off the line surprisingly crisply. I say surprising because the numbers at play are not exactly standouts. The electric motor produces 150 horsepower. The secret, however, lies in the torque. The electric motor twists out 273 pound-feet from rev 1. The combination delivers a 9.8 second run to 100k and an 80 to 120 passing time of 7.4 seconds. On the flip side, I managed a 1,000 kilometer average of 4.1 liters per 100 kilometers. True, this does not take into account the cost of recharging the main battery, but it is nonetheless the lowest average economy I have ever recorded. One of the drawbacks with electric vehicles is the fact that they're basically silent, so you tend to sneak up on pedestrians and give them a terrible surprise. Well, you could blow the horn, but you're liable to be told that you're number one. This Volt, it has a very polite way of saying, look out. Dynamically, the Volt is balanced. The suspension is comfortable without allowing too much body roll, the steering delivers decent feedback, and the brake pedal has some semblance of feel. It is still mushy when compared to a conventional pedal, but given the regen side, it proved to be remarkably easy to modulate. So there you have it, a full-on electric vehicle, albeit with an extended range. Now, that simple fact means that you will not get range anxiety, which is something that plagues all other electric vehicles. To quote my good friend and colleague Jim Kenzie, I have seen the face of the future, and it's wearing a bow tie.